Absolute value inequalities. Isolate the absolute value. Before setting up a compound inequality, we must first isolate the absolute value. Beware, with an absolute value, we cannot distribute. We're talking about through the absolute value, or combine unlike terms. Two common mistakes. Let's take a look at our examples. In example one, notice that we have some other things there besides our absolute value. So the first thing we want to do is get this isolated. So let's move our negative 2. Now have negative 7 times the absolute value of 3x plus 4 is less than negative 21. Divide by a negative 7. So now we have the absolute value of 3x plus 4. Because we are dividing, that absolute value has to change direction, so it's now greater than 3. Set up our two equations. One will be exactly as it's written. This is a greater than. So remember, that's going to be going off the two sides. And we have 3x plus 4. It's going to be less than negative 3. Don't forget to change the inequality on the second equation. We'll subtract 4 from both sides. We get 3x is greater than negative 1 divided by 3. So x is going to be greater than negative 1/3. Solve the other equation. And we're going to get 3x is less than negative 7. Divide by 3, so x is less than negative 7/3. Let's graph that. So if I draw my line, negative 7/3 is going to be down here, and negative 1/3 will be right here. We have the open dot because we do not have an equal. X is greater than negative 1/3, so that means it's going to positive infinity. X is less than negative 7/3, so that's going to negative infinity. And so our interval notation is going to be from negative infinity to negative 7/3, parentheses, union, negative 1/3, to infinity. Let's take a look at our second example. Again, we need to isolate our absolute value, so we're going to subtract 5 from both sides. We now have 2 times the absolute value of 4x minus 1 less than or equal to 12. Divide by 2. So now we have the absolute value of 4x minus 1 less than or equal to 6. We did not divide by a negative, so we do not have to change the direction of our inequality. So our two equations then are going to be 4x minus 1 is less than or equal to 6, and 4x minus 1 is greater than or equal to a negative 6. Don't forget to flip your inequality there. So solving the first equation, we're going to add 1 to both sides. We get 4x is less than or equal to 7. Divide by 4. And x is less than or equal to 7/4. add 1 to both sides. Again, we have 4x is greater than or equal to negative 5, divide by 4, and we get x is greater than or equal to negative 5/4. So let's graph that. So negative 5/4 is going to be down here, and our 7/4 will be here. We're going to have a closed dot this time. And remember that they'll always be the same. This is only true when we have absolute value. We have x is less than 7/4 and x is greater than negative 5/4. So this will be our graph. Our interval notation then will be from the bracket negative 5/4, 7/4, bracket.